Now to the bronze medal bouts. The final matches to decide who will take the medals away from Olympic competition on this final day. And the weight categories in doubt, the 66 kilogram division and the 96 kilogram division. And first we have the bronze medal bout for the 66 men's freestyle, 66 kilograms men's freestyle. And Ramazan Sahin of Turkey, who has come through the repechage beating Navrizov. And his opponent is Tanatarov of Kazakhstan, who lost the semi-final to Kumar, who is in the gold medal bout. So the losing semi-finalist meets the man who's come through the repechage. And normally you might expect that the losing semi-finalist would be the higher ranked opponent, but that's not necessarily the case, because the man in blue, Akzhurek Tanatarov, came 10th at the 2010 World Championships. His opponent, Ramazan Sahin, in recent years has performed very well. He is the Olympic gold medalist from Beijing. He was the world champion in 2007, the man in red. He finished 19th in 2010 at the World Championships and 20th in 2011. So I suppose you could say on that basis he has finished behind Tanatarov at the World Championship level. The direct comparison there of 2010 would be 19th for Sahin as a finish and a 10th as a finish for Tanatarov. But let's say there's not much between these two, and it should be a real duel, a real battle for the bronze medal. The right ear of Tanatarov has been taped up. He was bleeding from that ear in the semi-final with Kumar. The referee from the USA. He checks the men over. He says, let's begin this bronze medal bout. The last time they were at the Olympic Games 4 years ago, Sahin won the gold medal. Ramazan Sahin of Turkey in the red. Today he has a chance for a bronze medal. Tanatarov has had to recoup from losing the semi-final, where he had hopes of going on to a gold, but nevertheless, a bronze medal is much more than a consolation prize, I'm sure, particularly for he and his country, Kazakhstan. Tanatarov in the blue, under attack here early from Sahin. Referee warning against twisting the fingers. A leg attack by Sahin. He gets behind and scores. Scores a point. Now Tanatarov has to get the intent. And look at this maneuver to bring the shoulders over from Sahin. Spectacular. Scored another 3 points as he lifted himself right up off the shoulders and then brought himself down to lift his opponent. And the crowd loved it. Crowd loving that attacking spectacle from Ramazan Sahin. Of course, in lifting himself up, he puts himself in some peril, takes a risk to do it, but he scored 4 points, and that could carry him through as he's still on the... he's on the defensive here. And a good comeback here from Tanatarov, trying to turn his man over. Can he break his posture? No, I don't know that he can. Goes to tangle the legs now and can't do it. Good fight back nevertheless by Tanatarov after conceding the early loss of the 4 points. Now let's watch this again. The leg attack, and he gets behind, and then he will lift himself forward onto the shoulders and then come back and lever his opponent back over onto his shoulders. What a magnificent move on the ground. Reminiscent of the standing suplex. Sahin in the lead. Ramazan Sahin. His last couple of years have been a little bit lean at World Championships, and he didn't book his ticket to London until the final qualification tournament in May. He's attacking, but there's a counter here from Tanatarov, who's a force to be reckoned with. Don't count him out at all. So Tanatarov scores the first point of the second period in the first 30 seconds. Tanatarov took up wrestling at the age of 10, now 25 years old. Sahin is 29. And Sahin had the headlock, but the referee stepped in saying that he needed to have it more the upper arm rather than the lower end, which can turn into a choke. So 1 point to nil in the second period in favour of Azcuyrek Tanatarov of Kazakhstan. The Turk struggling hard for the force out, and I think he's got it. Sahin, yes, he's got that point, forcing Tanatarov to step out. So it's 1 point all now. A 1 point all duel here at the moment, and once again Tanatarov gets behind, but can he force his man down for the takedown? He lifts him and he'll try to force him down or turn him over like that. Good scoring move by Tanatarov for just the 1 point, but that could well be enough. Hasn't been registered yet. There is a challenge in from Sahin from the Turkish camp. Now, the referee did signal one more point, I thought, to Tanatarov, but as yet it hasn't registered. There was the takedown on the edge of the contest area. It's a point to blue. That was the... Yes, it is a point to blue. So now Azurek Tanatarov leading 3-1 with the challenge unsuccessful. 2 seconds remaining. So the bronze medal bout is going to be decided in the third period. Tanatarov levels it at one period each. 3 points to one. The first period went to Sahin, 4-1. With that spectacular throw of his onto the shoulders. Not quite so spectacular, but very effective this time from Tanatarov in the second period. So this is the decider, and the prize is a bronze medal. It's one period each between Ramazan Sahin of Turkey in the red and Azurek Tanatarov of Kazakhstan in the blue. And there is plenty of fight left in these two. You can see the determination and the leg attack from Tanatarov. He could force him into the danger position here if he can drive him back. He has, not for long, but he did have him momentarily. And now bridging up, Tanatarov, as the reversal comes from Sahin. Point scoring, though, for Tanatarov. He got the first two. Points coming to both. And Sahin has now scored with a couple of his own. Tanatarov leading 4-2 from that flurry of points. Action-packed wrestling. Desperation and determination for a bronze medal. Ramazan Sahin of Turkey in the red. Azurek Tanatarov of Kazakhstan in the blue. There's still a minute to go. The match appears to be opening up. A warning against the man in blue, Tanatarov. As they become a little more tired, this is going to really open up in this last minute. And now, after a leg attack, Tanatarov gets into the upper position, but can he take his man down? He is leading 4-2. Tanatarov leading 4-2, so he can control this bout from here. He'll be happy to get into a prolonged fight for a superior hold here in this position. Ramazan Sahin leaving no stone unturned. Can he pull his man down? Not yet. Tanatarov doesn't want to lose any points. Doesn't want to receive any cautions. He's keeping his distance now. Sahin coming after him. One eye on the clock. And he claims victory. And he claims a bronze medal. Well, that was a gritty contest between two fierce warriors for the bronze medal. Tanatarov was very disappointed and exhausted after he lost the semi-final to Kumar and had blood running from his right ear. Now he has defeated Ramazan Sahin of Turkey in a very tough contest. And it is Azurek Tanatarov who wins the first bronze medal. He took the first period 4-1. I should say Sahin took the first period 4-1. Tanatarov took the second 3-1. And Tanatarov the third period 4-2. And now draped in the flag of Kazakhstan, he celebrates a bronze medal. Obviously it means a lot to him. He is a very happy man. At the age of 25, an Olympic bronze medalist. Proud to carry that flag. And if he marches in the closing ceremony tonight at the London Games, he may have a bronze medal around his neck. He's certainly going to own it after the victory ceremony. He had Sahin in the danger position, came over, pinned a shoulder, couldn't bring about the fall because of the desperate resistance from Sahin, but he accumulated 4 points, and that has amounted to victory and a bronze medal for Azurek Tanatarov of Kazakhstan. Now the wrestlers coming out for the second bronze final in the 66 kilogram freestyle wrestling. Livian Lopez Azcuy of Cuba will meet Jabrayil Hasanov of Azerbaijan. So Hasanov has had three matches today. He eventually lost to Yonemitsu in the semi-final. Lopez Azcuy losing to Yonemitsu in the round of 16. Lopez Azcuy also in the qualification match, first match of the day for him, he was able to defeat Tagavi Komani. And Komani was the world champion, reigning world champion from Iran. The other candidate for a medal who was beaten fairly early in qualification was Alan Gogayev of Russia. He lost in qualifying to Yusupov. So now this bronze medal contest is underway between these two. Livian Lopez Azcuy of Cuba in the red. And Jabrayil Hasanov of Azerbaijan in the blue. Fighting for a grip. Hasanov holding the right wrist of Lopez and not letting go. You can see that lower body strength of Hasanov, those sturdy legs firmly planted. If he speaks to him though. 1 minute 20 already gone. They break away. Back they come. Head to head. Lopez showing how quick he can be. Threatened to go for the leg attack. And now a counter attack from Hasanov. And he could be able to lift him here and bring him into the danger position. Can he? Not quite. Scores now, surely. Desperate struggle. 2 points to Hasanov in blue, 3 points in fact. 2 points and then an additional point. And still they go on, but now 2 minutes is up. Jabrayil Hasanov of Azerbaijan takes the first period, 3-0. He was disappointed when he lost the semi-final. Very disappointed, but he's gone away. Had some energy, food and drinks, and back with a look at that hole there. One arm around the leg, one arm around the neck, and controlling his man despite the thrashing attempts of Lopez Azcuy to escape. Second period underway, and the man in the lead, Jabrayil Hasanov of Azerbaijan in the blue singlet, the world bronze medalist 2010 and 2011, and the European champion of 2011. His recent form obviously good. And his opponent, Lopez Azcuy in the red on the attack here, going for the body shot. Now trying to lift up, but here comes Hasanov again, trying to run around behind him. Lopez finishes on top and takes a point. So the Cuban puts his head in front in this second period. He is the world bronze medalist from 2011 and the Pan American champion of 2011. Cuban now 30 years old. Hasanov much his junior at 22. Down he goes, though. Lopez scores again. 2-0. Very intense look on the faces of the coaches. Not much emotion displayed by the wrestlers themselves. They are so intent and straining physically that they maintain their composure as much as possible. 20 seconds to go. Cuban down by 2 points in the second period, up by 2 points in the second period, having taken the first period. A few seconds remaining here as Hasanov goes on the attack once more. So, a good 2 minutes there for the Cuban, Lopez Azcuy. Lopez Azcuy bouncing back after losing the first period. 3 points to nil, takes the second, 2-0. There's the takedown for a point. Trying to turn Hasanov onto his back, but he came down on that side and the elbow tucked in underneath him. It's one period each, and the battle goes on for the bronze medal. This is men's freestyle, 66 kilogram, Olympic wrestling, highest caliber. They lock horns once more. Try to wear each other down. A more explosive attack now from Lopez Azcuy, going for the legs, but as is regularly the case, Hasanov very capable of the reversal, very capable of counter-attacking. And the Lopez Azcuy still on one knee, he can't get back up without risk. Back to the center. One minute to go. Who can break loose? Both trying their very best right here, right now. Lopez has a leg lock on Hasanov, but he breaks away, goes for it again, gets it again. No score yet. Hasn't been able to bring his opponent down, but he's got that leg trapped. Now, here comes Hasanov over the top and scores a point. Drove from on the ground, sideways, caught Lopez, has 1 point, and there's only 20 seconds remaining. So Hasanov will work him over. Neither with a great deal of energy left. This third period is sapping their strength. Only 15 seconds remaining now as Lopez attacks low. Now who's lifting? Who? Lopez is lifting and driving for 3 points. Look at that. What a throw. What a throw from Lopez Azcuy. He got the fall in the end. It was a grand amplitude throw that put Hasanov on his back, and that was a massive finish to the bronze medal contest. A 5 point throw from Lopez Azcuy of Cuba, a rarity in the Olympic competition. They are so evenly matched. And they were so evenly matched until that triumphant throw from Livian Lopez Azcuy, the Cuban Olympic bronze medalist. Done it in style. That was an exhibition of rare strength and timing. He certainly did do it in style. The crowd were out of their chairs. Hasanov, a broken man, disappointed to have lost the bronze and probably a little embarrassed to have lost it this way. So competitive up until this point. Here goes Lopez as he lifts and turns and brings his man down firmly on the back. And slams him down for 5 points. It wasn't actually a fall, but it was a magnificent throw for 5 points. So Lopez has the bronze medal for Cuba.